All right, here we are, game one between Wings and LGD Forever Young, and we get into this draft right away. A couple picks in as we take a look at the bans of Wings Gaming. We've got Monkey King and Legion Commander banned out by Wings, and for LFY, they've banned out the Cottle as well as the Tusk. Both teams, they go through their first two picks, Magnus for Wings and Troll Warlord sitting there at two, and then for LFY, Juggernaut and Rubik, so both these teams right now in this DPL season 3 have 4 points. LFY, they've got 2 wins and a loss. While Wings, they have 1 win and 2 splits. Both teams beat FTD Club C. LFY also beat CDEC. Wings also, then split with Newbie and VGJ. Two pretty solid teams in DPL this season. And then LFY, they did end up losing 2-0 to Vici. So we see the Crystal Maiden banned out, the Lina banned out by Wings, and they're banning that Tusk Crystal Maiden combination that we saw a couple times yesterday. You go in there, Snowball with the Frostbite, and it does get you some pretty good early aggression, and we saw a couple teams actually get First Blood with it. So with the lineups they have right now, Wings and LGD Forever Young, right now you could see Troll safe lane or mid, Magnus mid or off lane. We've seen those heroes in both those spots before, but I do like the Magnus in the off lane and then always giving off the Empower to his other cores. For LGD, FY, they've got the Jug who's probably going to be in that safe lane, and then Rubik who's going to be that support for him. So the ban of Dazzle from LFY. Does come out, and they're just trying to stop a little bit of the sustain on Wings with that Dazzle ban. A bunch of supports banned by LFY. And now the Medusa banned out by Wings. So something that does go well with the Magnus is Juggernaut, but obviously Juggernaut already on there for LFY. So you've got Jug, you've got Rubik, and maybe you go with something for your fifth. Your position 5 who's a slow, or maybe even put Rubik in the 5 spot and pick up a Pudge. Pudge is not too bad with a Rubik as well as a Juggernaut. That early aggression would be very nice with the Rubik-Pudge combination as well as a Jug. You get that Blade Fury out and really run down the offlane of Wings. So, we'll see what LFY choose to go with. They're getting pretty low on the reserve time, but probably just planning their next two picks out as they already see two cores on Wings Gaming, Magnus, and Troll. So, we'll have to see what they go with as they need an offlaner, they need a mid, and with that, they do pick up the Ember Spirit. And I like Ember Spirit with Juggernaut. The mobility of Ember Spirit's always nice. We'll see if he does end up going for that Veil. And then the setup's always there with the Rubik. You get a nice Telekinesis out. Ember Spirit comes in, Sleight of Fist, Searing Chains, and you can run it down with the Juggernaut. So some solid team fight for LFY thus far. And now Wings, they pick up the Earth Spirit. Earth Spirit, one of those heroes who is heavy aggression early. And if you have a good Earth Spirit, you know, he gets those stuns, gets those silences, and usually with the stun, Remnant stuns getting thrown out, he hits one or two heroes. And we'll see if the Earth Spirit for Wings is that good, how he does, and how many times he does come over mid, which can definitely be a problem for Ember Spirit. Before Ember Spirit hits that level 6, very susceptible to being ganked in the mid lane, and we'll have to see how it goes for him. And now LFY, they do pick up Bane. So Bane going to be that 5, Rubik in the 4. And then Jug, safe lane, Ember Spirit, mid. So, let's see what Wings do, kind of to combine with the three heroes they have right now and to go up against the heroes of LFY.
5 seconds remaining. Reserve time.
You know, what it looks like is they have an off lane as well as, I would say, Troll safe lane. Never know for sure. But their initiation is going to be the Earth Spirit rolling in with Rolling Boulder. And then later in the game, it will be once the Magnus has Blink. You know, look for a big Blink RP. and see what you can do from there. Let's see if Wings really go with someone heavy on the offlane, maybe a Tide. But, you know, that's if they put the Troll safe lane Magnus mid, they have an offlane available. So these two cores for Wings, I don't know where they're going just yet. LFY may have the same thing. They may not know exactly where the Troll or the Magnus are going to go. They're trying to play the lineup as well as they can. And Wings, they're picking up a Silencer. So it's going to be Silencer mid, Troll safe, Magnus offlane. Oh, we saw Silencer freeze do very well with that Silencer. So we'll see how it does up against LFY. I do like it up against this lineup of LFY. And I really do think Silencer has the opportunity to be very solid in these fights up against and for the side of Wings Gaming. Reserve time. So we get into these last bans. While Wings, they look to be looking for another support more in the four lane, so, or the four role. Looking for someone who can roam around and ultimately do well in the early game, roaming around and helping out these heroes of Magnus, Troll, and Silencer. They've already got the Earth Spirit who roams pretty well. Maybe they want someone who lanes very well with Troll. Someone who can support Troll optimally. And they take out the Wisp. They don't want the relocate, which would be very nice with Troll or Silencer, especially if Magnus goes in with the RP relocate into that fight. Now with Venge, it looks like it's going to be a Venge 4. Venge now has the magic missile. You've got the rolling boulder as your slow, but that's your only big, like, non-ultimate stun.
Tidehunter.
And then Tidehunter picked for LFY. So offlane is going to be Tide. So we've got Magnus, Troll, Earth Spirit, Silencer, Venge up against Jug, Rubick, Ember Spirit, Bane, Tidehunter. So I do like the early game of LFY, and the later it goes, I do like it more for Wings. So LFY have to be aggressive early, but again, Wings have a counter to that in both the Venge and the Earth Spirit. So Wings Gaming up against LFY, game one between these two teams in a set of two, not really a best of two. As both teams, they do have 4 points, and they are looking to move up in the rankings thus far. So we get ready to roll. Here we are. Wings, we're going to see why on the Venge. Over on the Troll is going to be Shadow. Silencer played by Blink. Over on the Magnus is going to be Faith Beyond. And then finally on the Earth Spirit is going to be Ice Ice. For the other side, LFY, we've got White on the Rubick. Super playing the Ember Spirit. LPC on the Bane. Tidehunter played by Jixing. And finally, Monet on the Jug. We'll see how these lanes kind of set up. Should be Jixing all alone with Bane and Rubick down low with Monet. Does give optimal opportunity for some kills. Super mid and then four Wings. Looks as though it's going to be Troll and Venge up top with Earth Spirit kind of roaming around as much as he can. Magnus, Faith Beyond in the offlane, and Blink over mid. So two top contenders are going to take it on in a best of two. Let's see if anybody could get a 2-0 win and get themselves 2 points, or if we're going to see ourselves a 1-1 split between these two teams.
The battle begins.
So, two bounty runes apiece. Shadow and Blink get it for Wings. Super and Monet for LFY. And with that, creeps are out, we're underway, we're ready to go, and let's see what happens. So like I said, Y is going to be up here. It is Shadow. We're going to see the Earth Spirit roaming around As Ice Ice already looking mid, but LPC is here just to block anything out. And there's the Rolling Boulder already coming through on LPC, gonna slow him up. And it looks as though LPC gonna get very low, but Super comes in with the Searing Chains. They try to turn it around on Ice Ice, and look at that salve off, but immediately canceled. LPC has to run away with just 48 health, and now the Rolling Boulder comes through all the way through to the Roche Pit. And LPC, he's got to play his game pretty safely as he is going to use that Brain Sap. Get himself a little bit of health. Push back Earth Spirit. Ice Ice. Going to have to go all the way back to base. Heal up and try again. But LPC just babysitting for Super, as he does stop the aggression from Earth Spirit and really opens up the lane for Super. There's the Arcane Curse thrown on too, getting both LPC and Super low. They gotta be very careful. There is a lot of regen for both the Ember Spirit and the Bane, but already having to pop that salve just a minute 30 into this laning stage is definitely a problem for the Ember Spirit early on. So Faith Beyond up against Monet and White. Take a look over at White with that first skill tick of Fade Bolt. And Monet's got the Blade Fury. We'll have to see once White hits level 2, gets that telekinesis, if him and Monet are going to try and get a kill out on this Magnus Faith Beyond with the telekinesis and Blade Fury. It's definitely going to be some trouble. And again, it looks to be dual lanes for both teams mid. Coming over is Super. Ice Ice looking towards that Arcane Rune, but he does get the Searing Chains in his face. It will back him off, and Super does get it. So just a little bit of rune control for LFY early on. Nothing too crazy. Now the Rolling Boulder comes through onto LPC. He's found himself a little bit of trouble. There's the Arcane Curse as well as the Searing Chains out on Blink. But again, it's just back and forth with a little bit of pot shots from both teams. Now backing off both Ice Ice and Blink. So just these two babysitters for both sides. Ice Ice for Wings, LPC. LFY, it's really just a back and forth between the two, really looking for their first openings to get first blood, where I actually do think it's going to come in a different lane. I do believe it will be Rubick and Jug. That's just a little prediction from me, but I mean, if you've watched me in the past, my predictions are almost never right. And like I said, LPC, he'll be moving down first. They get first blood on Wings. It's going to go the way of Blink, and already minus two for LPC. So Wings lead 1-0 early on. Get that first blood on Silencer. Already has him to Stolen Intelligence. And Silencer, you know, like him or not, he can snowball pretty hard. He's involved in a couple of kills. All of a sudden, he's got 10 Stolen Intelligence. Things get hard for LFY. And you just see a Silencer kind of ball out against the other team like we did the other day with Freeze. So with Bane falling, with LPC dead, he's going to make his way over top. Just throw a ward over there. He's probably not going to babysit mid anymore. Neither is Ice Ice. And we'll see if he goes a different direction, maybe heading towards bottom to help out Faith Beyond. So we take a look at the last hits. It's Jug, Monet with 24 and 7. Then the next three are all on Wings. So LFY not exactly having the best time in any of these lanes as mid. Super's only 9 and 5. So with that haste, LFY, or LPC, just trying to harass out. I was right with LFY, just the right name of the hero. And LPC, now he's going to move over top. So he's just trying to harass out Y, maybe just push him back. But now here, with Jixing, they might be able to find something. There's the magic missile, and Shadow goes in. LPC might have found himself a little bit of trouble. The Rolling Boulder's in. Jixing and LPC, both stunned by Ice Ice. And the Nightmare comes out onto the Venge just to slow them down a little bit, but LPC still getting very low. And a couple of more shots would bring him down. He turns around to get that Brain Sap, gets him a little bit more health, and survives with just 14 HP. So he does end up surviving just barely. And we'll have to back off towards that Shrine. Heal on up, but again, it's not looking really that great for LFY in any of these lanes. Really, Monet's the only one doing okay. But other than that, It seems to me that all these lanes have been won by Wings. So we take a look over at Blink. Seems to be going for possibly the treads. We'll see if he turns that into a Midas. And then down low, we take a look over. Monet has the phase boots already. Faith Beyond, just boots for himself and the poor man's shield. And really, we want to take a look at the items of Shadow. He's got the phase boots. He's looking for the Aqua. And we'll definitely have to see what he looks to pick up from there. But Shadow, with this Venge, I don't think they're going to be able to get any kills on Jixing. Jixing, a very hard hero to kill early on. Of course, Ice Ice is now up top, so maybe the three of them can find something, but he's already got two in Kraken Shell and three in Anchor Smash, so Jixing, one of those hard heroes to kill in the early game, and definitely hard for the likes of Wings, as Shadow and Ice Ice are not going to be enough. So again, we take a look over mid, Super trying to get that level 6 as Blink, he's already there, has Global Silence, and down low, there's the Nightmare with the Blade Fury trying to skewer out his Faith Beyond, but he gets hit with the Telekinesis. That should be enough for Monet to get the kill, and he will, and they now tie the game up at 1, and Monet grabs himself the first kill for LFY. So a nice kill there for LFY, getting them a little bit of a push on net worth for Monet. Looking towards that Aqua as well. And that is going to stunt the farm of Faith Beyond for just a little bit longer. He's going for that Arcane Boots and possibly the Blink Dagger next. So we'll see if Super does end up going for the Veil. It's been pretty standard build for Ember Spirits recently in the meta. But actually the last couple games I haven't seen an Ember Spirit go for it. They've gone Blink Lincolns. So Super just backs up to Shrine. LPC will sit over mid. Has two in that Brain Sap and one in the Nightmare. So he did use that Nightmare down low to help Monet get the kill. They teamed it up with White on the Rubick to get that Telekinesis, as well as Monet with the Blade Fury. And a kill for Monet is going to push him forward. He's looking for the Wand next, and then most likely going to go straight to that Manta style. So LFY, they now have Ravage. No Blink just yet on the Tidehunter. He's going to be going for the Arcane Boots. I'm not too sure he's going to be going for the Blink overall. He could just go Arcane Boots into a mech, get his team the Guardian Greaves early. But that's really up to Jixing and what LFY feel is necessary. Their team fight's pretty solid with the Ember Spirit, who can come around with the Sleight of Fist as well as the Searing Chains under that Ravage. And then on top of all that, of course, we do have Monet, who could find himself getting a couple of kills with the Omni Slash. So over mid, Ice Ice is going to fall to Super. They are going to use the Global Silence. It doesn't even keep him alive. So it's a waste of a Global Silence and a kill going the way of LFY, and up to this point, it looks pretty good for them. They're not going to pull off the gas just yet. They smoke up with Monet and LPC. They're looking for a kill up top on Shadow. They have the Ravage to work with, but he doesn't have enough mana just yet. He's 30 mana short. With the pressure being felt from Jixing, Shadows has to know that something's up. And there it is. He walks into the hands of LPC and Monet. There's the Nightmare. Let's see what they get with the Blade Fury coming out. LPC gonna get that Brain Sap. Let's see if Monet can get the Omni Slash off. He's falling a little bit far back, and now Y's here with the Magic Missile. So they're still running away, still trying to get that Omni Slash, but they backed off enough to get out of harm's way. So they do push back Shadow, and they are looking towards taking this tier 1. No real rotations from Wings just yet, and we'll see if they do choose to rotate or just to sit back and really farm up a little bit more. They feel the pressure coming in from LFY. They don't want to be put back on their heels, and we'll have to see what Wings choose to do next. You know, they're losing this tier 1 tower. It's down via Monet. Nobody ends up making any rotations out. So So LFY, they don't use Omni Slash, they don't use the Ravage, so the team fight's still there as we take a look down low. Faith Beyond getting low to about half health. There's the Fade Bolt! And even despite the Magnetize, LFY are going to find another, so it's now 3-1. The Rolling Boulder's out, goes across the bow of Jixing. Looking for the telekinesis is Rubik, but it's just off cooldown as the rest of the Wings back off. So again, they don't end up using Ravage. And when you know Ravage is up, you know Ravage is available, Wings are going to be very hesitant about going in, because they can initiate, find themselves eventually when this Magnus gets a blink. Blinks in, gets the RP, it could be immediately nullified by a Ravage, and they don't want to take that chance. They know they're down 3-1 right now. They know it's a bit of a problem as they see themselves down 2,000 net worth to LFY. And if they get a little bit too cocky about their play and go in deep on LFY, Jixing, again, will just use that Ravage. Kind of reset the fight for LFY and maybe turn it around with both the Omni Slash as well as the damage ability from Ember Spirit. So Shadow up top, and Monet knows this, and here comes the rotation from LPC. They're going to try and take out Shadow once more, and coming through is Monet. Monet just going to fight with Shadow, and there it is. There's the ulti from LPC, and the Global Silence is going to stop it short, but now trying to turn it around is Shadow. The Brain Sap comes through, and just surviving with a tick of health is Monet, as LPC gets credit for the kill on Shadow. So now 4-1, they don't even use the Omni Slash, they use Fiend's Grip to get the kill. Stopped by the Global Silence, but they do end up finishing him off with the Brain Sap, and now the Yasha comes out for Monet. We take a look over at Super. Looks as though he's going to be finishing off that Veil in just a moment, and then let's take a look at over at the Heroes of Wings, as Arcane Boots are out for Faith Beyond. We take a look over at the Silencer, who's got that Midas, looking for a Rod of Atos next. And then Shadow, who's only got that Morbid Mask and Phase Boot. So, Troll Warlord, his farm sits 1,200 behind Monet on the Juggernaut, and he's doing very well right now. Already picking himself up that Yasha, looking to finish off that Manta Style as quickly as he can. So, LFY looking for an opening and TPing in and making the rotation is Blink. Wings, they don't look to defend this tier 1, but they might defend the tier 2. They do end up getting the glyph off. Super coming across with that Invis rune. Let's see if he can lock anybody up with the Searing Chains and have the ability to get Tidehunter in and throw that Ravage. So there's the sentry. They actually do end up spotting Super. There's the swap back in. The Ravage a little bit too late. It's out on Y. That will grant LFY a return kill. But Super gets found out with a nice prediction from Wings with that Sentry Ward. So Super very far forward. They felt that the whole team was there mid. They know they didn't have any eye on Super. They do drop the Sentry Ward. It's in the right spot. They do get the kill on the Ember Spirit. They lose one in return, but a core for a support. Always a beneficial trade for the team losing the support and not the core. So 5-2 for LFY. Faith Beyond down here, but he's going to get lit up by that Fiend's Grip. And now coming over with the Remnants is going to be Ember Spirit, but there's the Global Silence to save Faith Beyond's life. So again, we've seen this Global Silence come out time and time again defensively for Wings. Really ability you want to use aggressively. When you're using it defensively, you know you're behind in the game, and you know you're having a little bit of trouble controlling around the map. Now that they've got that Global Silence down and Ravage back up in 76 seconds, maybe they look to be aggressive on LFY. Of course, they're not going to have that Ravage for over a minute. Meanwhile, up top, White's going to find a kill on Ice Ice. Now 6-2 for LFY. So, bottom, we actually miss another kill of Faith Beyond. And now Shadow coming in, trying to clean up, trying to get the kill on Super. He's still silenced up, but there's the Remnant forward, finds himself a little bit of space between him and the side of Wings. And now it looks as though Y is going to try and get himself a kill, but the Sleight of Fist coming out with the Searing Chains. Y very low with the Brain Sap coming through from LPC. Shadow gonna push him back with those whirling axes, and now Super's just gonna back off, heal up, and then come back into the fight. They know the Remnant's near, and they know on the side of Wings that they want to stay close just in case. So they're just gonna heal up with this shrine, stay close, and there they are with the smoke, looking to make an aggressive play. So they come on over, LPC in a little bit of trouble. There's the Wave of Terror with the Searing Chains coming out on two with the Gush, and there it is. Swap back with Fiend's Grip from LPC in a very nice spot, but there's a big stun and silence coming out from Ice Ice. So they look to get the kill on Super. They do, not before they lose Y on the Venge, and now Blink trying to run with his life, but he's not going to make it out. A big stun on three from the Earth Spirit Ice Ice, who's now going to try and TP out. Doesn't have a TP, not enough money to even purchase one, so he's got to try and run away. Hides himself in the trees, gets spotted out by LPC, and now they know he's here. The rest of LFY are going to join him. They're trying to finish off this first to 10 kills. He gets enough money to buy that TP, rolling boulders off, and gets the TP out. So 9-3 for LFY, and we take a look at that net worth, now getting up there towards the 4,000 side for net worth and 4,000 for XP. So with those couple of kills, they're going to try and take this tier 1 bottom. They're going to get it uncontested by Wings. And 9-3 with an okay lead for LFY. They're just going to look to continue to be aggressive, continue to extend their lead, and make it harder and harder for Wings to get to that optimal late game that they want to find themselves at. Take a look over at Super. He's got himself that Veil. Now looking for the Boots of Travel. He'll be the split push kind of mobile hero for LFY. He's going to be trying to keep the pressure on Wings so they feel uncomfortable making a move throughout this game. So Shadow, Faith Beyond, and Y up top. We haven't really seen an optimal RP, and that's because he's waiting for this Blink. He's 100 gold away from getting it. And that's maybe where Wings are going to be looking to try and take teamfights. We've seen Shadow do all right in the teamfights. That hasn't gotten them that many kills, but if they can line that up with a nice RP, and Shadow has a moment to really go off with the Empower, maybe Wings start taking a couple kills and taking these team fights a bit more decisively or even at all. So Shadow gonna go for that early BKB. Meanwhile, smoked up is LFY. They've got four smoked up in Y, LPC, Jixing, and Super. Now the Rod of Atos finished off for Blink. So let's see if LFY head towards these Ancients and maybe try to find something on Shadow. As Shadow, he's shown himself, and now there's the Flame Guard from Super. Coming over with a big four-man RP is Faith Beyond. They try to turn around with the skewer. Here comes a Ravage on the entire side of Wings. They're getting very low. They've already lost all five, and five die on Wings, only losing one on LFY. They turn it around with a whole team Ravage, and the Veil Sleight of Fist with the Remnants from Super, and Monet coming through with the Omni Slash is enough to take this big fight. For LFY, they clean up the entire side of Wings, and they'll continue on towards this bottom tier 2 and maybe even look for a tier 3. So a huge fight for LFY. They take out everybody on Wings. Now they had to take this stack of Ancient Creeps, and that'll push them towards a 10,000 marker on the net worth lead. LFY looking very good in this game one of this set of two. So off that, we saw an amazing RP come through from Faith Beyond, but just wasn't enough. He locked down a lot of the heroes of LFY, but then came in the Ravage from Jixing. Now with those Guardian Greaves, and just hits the whole team, and exactly what I was saying before, they can go in. They can go in with the RPs on Wings, try and clean it up, but if they use it while Ravage is still online, the fights can turn around in a heartbeat, and right there you saw exactly that. So Wings, they're in a lot of trouble, down 14-4. Gotta really pull themselves out of a deep hole. Shadow farming pretty well at 8,100 net worth. Leading the net worth is Monet. He's got himself that Manta style, now looking for a Diffusal Blade. Let's see if LFY look to go for Roche soon. So they are going to TP down low. They're going to look to rotate, try and find themselves a couple of kills. Blinking in with the telekinesis is White going to slow down Shadow. There's the Gush to follow it up. Jixing trying to chase down Shadow and Faith Beyond as they're trying to run their way out. Here comes a nice stun from the Earth Spirit, but still moving forward is Monet. Monet trying to have them turn around as he knows the rest of the team is there for him on the back end for LFY. And he tries to force it out, but won't, and Wings will fully retreat. So LFY look very good with the Guardian Greaves out on Jixing. We take a look at Super. He's got himself that Veil, and now the Boots of Travel moving around this map and farming very well. But here comes Blink, Y, and Shadow. And remnanting out right away is LFY, and they do get a four-man smoke. They're looking to be aggressive off that play as they do spot a couple up top for Wings. So they're going to make their move all the way up there, try to take another fight. They have Ravage. They have everything they need. All the ultimates are up for LFY. If it's anything like the last one, they could be looking at another team wipe, as it doesn't look as though Wings are ready. Ice Ice is going to spot them out, and now they come over. There's the Glimmer Cape. Monet spots Ice Ice, and he's in a little bit of trouble. There's the Nightmare with the Blade Fury, and it's another kill for LFY, now 15-4. So Wings feeling the aggression. They look for a Tier 1 of their own, and they do get it, but now they're going to lose a Tier 2, so the trade not exactly optimal. And there is a ward deep from Wings over by that Tier 1 tower, and they're going to look to get a Tier 2 of their own, but they're going to be forced to rotate back as LFY, they push these creeps all the way to that Tier 3. Force back Wings, who really want to try and even it up by getting themselves a Tier 2 up top, but they're not even going to be able to find it as they're forced back, as their Tier 3 already taking damage just 22 and a half minutes into the game. Wings, it's going to be a tough road to climb. They really need to try and extend the game as long as they can, and they're really hoping to get a BKB out on Shadow to take that first step. They've got the Rod of Atos out for Blink, looking for a Hurricane Pike, or they've got the Rod of Atos, yeah, Rod of Atos out for Blink, and they are looking for the Hurricane Pike next, and now the Blink Dagger is here for Jixing, going to be finding even more optimal positioning to get those big Ravages out. So they end up getting another kill on Earth Spirit, who's been picked off a couple times in this game, sitting 0-5-4. LFY, they're making it look easy this game, up 16-4. Take a look up top. Jixing getting very low. He's going to have to use those Guardian Greaves. He still has Ravage. There's the RP. And let's see if they come around. There's the Bash, and now the Veil's out. Global Silence comes through to stop the Ravage from coming out from Jixing. And now they might be able to pick off Super. He's found himself a little bit of trouble. He'll fall as well. And this is what Wings needs to really change up this game. They get another one in LPC. And three, just like that, will die in LFY. Coming in with the Omni Slash is Monet. He's going to use that Magic Style. They get a kill from White with the Fade Bolt. And there's the Magnetize out on both White and Monet. Rolling Bouldering in, or coming in with the Rolling Boulder, is Ice Ice. But it doesn't look as though they're going to be able to find White. So they take out three on LFY. They get one back in Blink. But overall, it's a pretty solid fight for Wings. And this is what they need to do to crawl themselves out of the big 10,000 net worth deficit they're up against. So, Wings, if they can do that a couple more times and try not to lose Blink, when they do it, we could see them really crawling themselves out, and the later this game goes, I do like it more for Wings. So, LFY, they might want to look to keep the aggression on and kind of extend that lead even more. Wings, they definitely have the ability to push with the Empower and Shadow on the Troll Warlord. They really do have some pretty good team fight with it there, too. If they could get the Empower out on Troll, get the big RP that they had last time without the Ravage coming through, they might have been able to take that fight, but unfortunately, Jixing was there, got the Ravage out, because Global Silence used a little bit too early. There's a Blink in with a Ravage, but only Gonna hit Ice and Y, and now coming over with the skewers, Faith Beyond. They move on through. They're gonna get this kill on Y. The BKB is popped by Shadow. He's trying to get a kill on White, but he hasn't found anything just yet. There's the Fiend's Grip from LPC. A big RP on two. And now they turn around to get themselves a kill on White. Monet's trying to look on through, trying to get the kill on Shadow, and they will get it. But Monet will end up falling a Blink. Blink continuing to hit away at Jixing. There's the skewer through from Faith Beyond. And they end up getting three while losing just the Troll and the Venge. And they're going to get another with that Arcane Curse out on LPC. So they take four again on LFY. So Wings doing a good job at winning these fights and pulling themselves back out. So on top of all that, Wings, they're going to find themselves the Roche, get the Aegis out on Blink. And Wings are starting to feel themselves. LFY, they now got to be a little bit more careful. They've lost two fights in a row. Maybe they're going to start to be a little bit less aggressive, extend their lead with a little bit of farming, and then maybe look for the optimal time to push. But for now, they should probably just sit back for a little bit and get their next items out. So over on Shadow has the SNY. We did see that BKB debuted in that last fight. Did work wonders for Shadow as they grab themselves four for Wings. Shadow ultimately ends up dropping, but when you take four for two, you'll be happy with that trade, especially taking out the cores of LFY. So they get the bottom tier one. They take these towers pretty quickly. Let's take a look over at Blink. He's got 20 stone intelligence. Now has that Hurricane Pike with the Rod of Atos looking for the BKB next. That BKB on Blink would be very nice to keep him alive up against the side of LFY. Of course, once it's used, you are susceptible to the Fiend's Grip, which we saw in the last fight as Shadow got Fiend's Gripped up, but still managed to get himself and his team a kill on Monet. So they take the tier one, they take the tier two, and Wings, right there, they really show how quickly they can push right on back. So Shadow really starting to move forward, sits third in the net worth, but top of the net worth right now is Blink. Just a touch above this jug. So now they've taken three towers and no engagement from LFY at all. They know they kind of have to get these next items to feel comfortable taking a fight, but you've now lost a tier one, a tier two bottom, and now a tier one mid. Wings, they might be looking to fight. Wings over as four. There is a smoke on Y. Maybe they look to use it and be aggressive, and they are stacking up as though they are going to go, and there it is. So Faith Beyond, Blink, Y, and Ice all smoked up, looking to be aggressive towards LFY as they start feeling that this is their time to really make something happen, and they're going to march down mid looking for some of these members on LFY who are all sitting by this tier 2 tower. So Shadow gonna show himself over mid, and now Blink is gonna show himself with the smoke. He's gonna take this tier two. So four straight uncontested towers from LFY. Taken by Wings, and it's really ultimately serving to be an issue for LFY. They really just don't feel comfortable taking a fight at all. After getting lit up in the last two engagements, looks as though Wings, they're the ones looking to be the aggressors, while LFY, they're just looking to sit back. So take a look over at Super. Has that Yule's going for Mjolnir next. A little bit of utility on him with that Yule's, a little bit more lockdown for him. We'll see what he can do with that with the Sleight of Fist and Searing Chains. We take a look over at Jixing. He's going to be looking for the Shiva's Guard next. And actually switches it up afterwards. Or no, he's going to still go for that Shiva's Guard. Thought he switched up with the added items on the side. we take a look. LFY, they're still just trying to stay around the map, continuing to farm. And Monet's got that Diffusal Blade looking for a butterfly next, not too far away from it. But they're just ultimately trying to avoid Wings at all costs while still being able to farm and push these creep waves out. Looking for the Aether Lens is why we take a look over again at Shadows, looking for the Scotty. And not too far off of it, just only 400 gold. We'll get the next couple of creep waves back off towards that secret shop and finish it off. And this is where Shadow can really start doing a lot of damage towards LFY. It's top of the net worth, then followed by Blink. And LFY, where they once had a lead, it is now deteriorated for a lead for Wings at 30 minutes in. So the game has gotten late enough where I myself feel like Wings have the advantage. And it does show with the net worth, with the experience, and really with the last two engagements going their way heavily. LFY, they're really hoping on a big Ravage, but if they don't find it, their teamfight kind of falls off afterwards, and with the global silence, the RP, and the magnetize, and just everything coming out from Shadow with the Empower on him, the teamfight's pretty solid at this point in time for Wings. So BKB finished off for Blink. Let's see if Wings really start to pick up the aggression as they have one more outer tower to deal with up top, and that looks to be what they're going for next, pushing out this creep wave. And again, it doesn't look as though LFY are going to look to contest the tower, as I'm not too sure they feel too confident in their teamfighting abilities right now. They just look to push back these creep waves down bottom and middle to really force Wings back. So just like that, Wings, they'll get the last outer tower for LFY, or on LFY's side. I'll wait for this Roche, grab that Aegis, and probably from there really look to push on forward and possibly look to finish up this game. Take a look over at Faith Beyond. He's got that BKB as well, looking for the refresher next. Has a gem ready to go just in case. And while we take a look at LFY, it seems as though they just are lacking. After those last two engagements, just seeing them go down so easily. Got the Guardian Greaves, the Blink Dagger out for Tidehunter. You've got Super, he's found himself the Veil, Boots of Travel, now the Maelstrom, so he'll be able to push out a little bit better. You have to wonder if that's going to be enough for LFY to really come back in this game. So all the cores on Wings have BKB, making that Ravage not as effective and making the team fight look very advantageous for Wings. Blink hitting pretty hard, Shadow still doing work, now has the Scotty. All signs are really pointing towards a Wings win, but meanwhile, Shadow got on by Super, and now coming through is Ice Eyes trying to get the stun. He does get the silence. Rolling Boulder gonna miss. There's the Yules out on Shadow. Sleight of Fist as well as the Searing Chains. The Magnetize stopping Super. He's dusted up Scotty. Slowing down Super, trying to get that Remnant out. He does Remnant to find himself a little bit of distance. There's the swap back. Super still in a bit of trouble. The entire side of Wings has made their way over. And they will end up getting themselves a kill on the Ember Spirit, now dead for 70 seconds. So Wings, they team up to find a kill on Ember Spirit. And they have now gotten themselves a 5,000 net worth lead. Let's see if Shadow can push all the way towards the tier 3 and take this tower. So here to defend is Jixing and White. waiting back with that smoke is Faith Beyond. Take a look over top, and LPC is going to be the next one to drop from LFY. Wings get themselves another kill, this time on a support that's found himself a little bit too far out. They've got the Solar Crest out on Y. They hit that much harder with both Faith Beyond and Shadow with that Midas armor. And again, all signs really just pointing towards Wings. They're waiting for that Roche to respawn, and it's up. So Wings, the Solar Crest with Shadow, with the attack speed and everything, they're going to look to take this quick Roche, and with the Aegis, let's see if they push that Tier 3, knowing that Ember Spirit doesn't have buyback, and they're really sitting on their heels on the side of LFY. Get the Aegis out on Shadow. Let's see the push commence for Wings. So five here from Wings, and trying to split push bottom is Super on the Ember. But he's going to have to be forced back eventually, as he can only push so fast. Side of Wings, they hit these towers and take these towers very quickly. Moving on forward is Jixing. There's the swap, but the Lotus Orb is going to stop that now. Coming through a Shadow, he might be able to get him. The RP from Faith Beyond. I don't think he got that blink off. Gets stopped, and the RP is going to be in a terrible spot, getting nobody. There's the Ravage coming out on Y as well as Blink. They're going to be able to get themselves a kill on Y. And now they come with a skewer on over from Faith Beyond. The Global Silence is here through. There's the Dust. Super's going to find himself another kill. They've now taken out Blink. They've taken out Y, and Monet might be in a little bit of trouble. There's the Fiend's Grip coming through on Shadow. He's getting very low, and they'll finally pop that Aegis. They're going to be looking to take him out again. Let's see if they can do it. Here's Monet with the Blade Fury coming over. It's Jixing, and they lock him down well enough to get another kill on Shadow. And LFY, not only do they defend, but they take out three on Wings. So LFY, they do a very good job of holding, and now they look to take a tier 3 of their own, as they've already got one mid and now looking to take the Rax. So they force the buyback of Shadow. He's got to be very careful. There's the Magnetize. Huge RP on a 5. And now 1, 2, 3, 4 have dropped. They're just trying to get Jixing. He's got that Lotus Orb out, but it doesn't look as though it's going to be enough. There's the Magic Missile to follow it up. And it is an ultra kill for Shadow, getting 4 kills as they wipe LFY trying to get themselves Rax. Wow. So Wings, a huge RP from Faith Beyond. And then followed up by Shadow, just cleaning it up with the Empower, and the whole side of LFY is down. Wow. Wings, they've now extended that lead. The graph will probably update in a moment. They're going to force the buyback out from Super, as Wings, they look to take their first Tier 3. There's the Veil thrown forward. Shadow, no more Aegis. He was forced to buy back. So they do have to play it a little bit safe for Wings, knowing that they can't let Shadow die again. Let's see if they can grab this Tier 3. Really shouldn't be too hard. So staying high ground is Wings. Still looking to finish off this Rax. They get the melee Rax, and they'll retreat from there. See if LFY look to chase. They only have 3, so it's probably not the best of ideas. And again, they already bought back on Super, so they can't afford to lose him either. So take a look over at Troll, sitting almost level 25. He's got the plus 40 damage as well as the 6 armor and 7 strength. See what he chooses next between the minus 7 seconds whirling axes cooldown and the plus 20 magic resistance. Might take the cooldown in this matchup, but he's almost close to 25, and we'll see where he goes once he gets it. Faith Beyond, RP still available, or now available again. They've got the Global Silence, and LFY, they might be looking to push. They went in pretty aggressive with that smoke, but not finding anything. They'll have to back up, clean these creep wave up top. and ultimately clean up creep waves everywhere as it's pushing in on mid. So there's the dust, it's gonna spot LPC. Stun's gonna miss, he's still silenced up and the magnetize is out, the rolling boulder through. And there's the nightmare on ice. Let's see if LFY can turn it around. They've got a couple over here, but now Wings are starting to make the rotation. So LFY, they don't feel very comfortable about going in on this. And now it looks as though LPC, he'll lose his life. But it is a sacrifice to keep the rest of LFY alive. So up top is Wings. They're going to look to get another tier 3, possibly find themselves another set of racks. They come in pretty quickly. Blinking forward is Jixing, maybe not the best of moves. And now there's the swap out. They get Shadow out. There's the global silence. And Wings, they're still looking to fight. They've got the BKB with the skewer coming through. Faith Beyond gets a kill on Super. They're looking to get more on Jixing. The global silence is there. And they'll get themselves 3 as Super and Jixing fall. Still have Bane dead from before, and LPC just like that will call GG, and Wings will get game one. So game one goes the way of Wings. They're looking to take a sweep 2-0 as they're looking to push past LFY in this group stage, as they both had 4 points, now 5 points for Wings. We'll be back in just a moment with game two. I'm your caster, BCop, on Twitter, at BCop92. And we'll be right back.